This morning, Indonesia Now's Kartika Oktaviana discusses a new, more patient-friendly therapy for cancer. Hi, good morning. I'm here with Professor Ola Wingfis, a professor of cellular immunotherapy from Karolinska Institute in Sweden. We will talk more about cellular immunotherapy, which has the potential to be a highly targeted alternative because of its low toxicity, but then high capacity to eradicate tumor compared to other standard therapies. So good morning, Professor Ola.
Good morning.
So cellular immunotherapy, probably people in Indonesia, we don't know yet about that. Can you explain that about that therapy to us?
I'll be happy to. You know, your own immune cells have the capacity to fight off infections, but they are also your guard against cancer, against tumors. But unfortunately, 25% of the population will die from cancer. We have chemotherapy, we have surgery, we have irradiation, but when you have severe cancer form, there is a poor prognosis. But with the use of your own immune cells that can be harvested and taught to fight, they can be multiplied, so you have a fantastic, large, very well motivated army that could be sent back into the patient as a vaccination. We have done some clinical trials in Sweden that are very promising, and I'm now here discussing with colleagues in oncology and surgical oncology to create clinical trials here in Indonesia.
Mm-hmm. So what are the differences between this therapy and other standard therapies?
The regular therapy against cancer is taking the advantage of drugs that will inhibit and kill cells are about to divide. Mm-hmm. There's a high number of cell divisions occurring in a tumor. Mm-hmm. But you get side effects. Mm-hmm. Immune cells, cells in your gut or in your hair, will actually also be affected. Mm-hmm. Here, we're using the immune cells that have a long life. They will be memory cells. As you get the vaccination against polio, for example, you will have a lifelong protection against the polio virus. Mm-hmm. Here, the idea is to, in the test tube, provide a long-term memory against your own tumor cells. Mm-hmm. So the big advantage is that it's a long-term treatment and you will have a memory without the risk of getting any side effects.
So is it true also that you have done research on how to detect breast cancer immediately? Is the process painful?
Not at all. I mean, the way we have been doing it is to investigate for circulating tumor cells in the blood. Mm-hmm. So it's a sampling of blood. It should be pointed out that the idea is to use this when you evaluate a patient where you already have demonstrated or you believe that the patient has a tumor. Mm-hmm. So use the blood as a source to find the signal of a breast cancer. So it's not painful at all, it's just giving a blood sample.
Okay, so is there any message that you can tell to the people, to the audience, to give our viewers a knowledge about health and cellular immunotherapy?
Yes, I mean, immunotherapy is quite an interesting way of going after diseases such as cancer. If we talk about immune-mediated diseases, we have been thinking about doing the opposite. Instead of adding cells, yep, we have the capacity to remove cells. Mm-hmm. So we have actually created a small medical device, a column. Ah. And this is like dialysis.
Okay.
By having the blood passing over the column, mm-hmm, we can eliminate the bad cells, the cells that will go into the joint and destroy the joint, giving you pain and rheumatoid arthritis, or the cells that are going to the gut, giving you inflammatory bowel disease, or to the brain, giving you multiple sclerosis. Mm-hmm. So by passing the cells over the column, we can, without introducing any drugs into the patient, mm-hmm, eliminate the bad players from the equation. So we think cellular immunotherapy, either adding cells for colon cancer or breast cancer to eliminate tumor cells by using the immune system, or by eliminating cells in the immune system that cause damage, we can control and treat patients without adding any toxicity.
But all the things are done outside of the patients?
Yes.
Outside of the body?
Yes, that is the beauty by many of the cellular immunotherapy approaches, that you do not add any toxicity and you do not introduce anything foreign. Mm-hmm. It's your own cells that are eliminated, or it's your own cells that are added to your body to fight your own tumor.
Mm-hmm. And then how does it work after that? So you put all the cells that has been multiplied to the body, and when will it be?
It takes, from the surgery, you harvest the lymph node containing the T cells, the immune cells that recognize the tumor. Mm-hmm. You cultivate them and multiply them during a period of 1 month.
1 month.
And after that, you will have a blood transfusion. So the cells will be returned during a 1 hour procedure.
Ah.
And then you will have a memory. We have found the memory in blood more than 4 years uh-huh. after treatment. So we think we actually create a lifelong memory against your own tumor.
Okay, so this is such a great innovation. What is the success rate of this therapy?
As you always have to do when you start with treating patients with cancer, you start with the worst cases. So we have started with stage 4 disease, meaning that you have a disseminated disease with metastasis in lungs, in livers, or in skeleton. And there the success rate is about 20-25%, and in some diseases up to 30%.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
We think that this is a therapy that should be tried out a little bit earlier, mm-hmm. where you actually have a good functioning immune system, and then we hope that the response rate will be even better.
Professor Ola Wingfist and his research group was awarded the Athena Prize, the most prominent prize in clinical research, in November 2013.